should stay, I would only be in your way. So I'll go, but I know I'll think of you each step of the way, and I will always love you. I will always love you. Bittersweet memories. That's all I am taking with me. Goodbye, please don't cry. We both know that I'm not what you need. Treats you kind, and I hope that you have all that you ever dreamed of, and I wish you joy and happiness. But above all of this, I wish you love.
Good evening, everybody. Welcome to Gootz's Disney Pod. We're back live at the Gootz Cave, and I'm here today with my special guest once again after a two-year absence, Allan Fuks. Allan, how are you feeling?
Never better.
Feeling good?
I'm feeling good.
Feeling good to be back?
Feels so good.
To be back on the Gootz's Disney Pod?
I like this. We do it every 2 years.
Yeah, well, we might do it. I'm doing more Marvel stuff, I think, in 2022, so it might be back in a year.
Okay.
We're talking Spider-Man Far From Home, but before we do that, Allan, the last time we were on the show was November of 2019, a pivotal year in our lives.
Right.
Pivotal month. What have you been doing since then?
Let's see. I guess a lot of masturbation.
Yeah,
That's been fun. Mm-hmm. Did a lot of fun sketches. I'm doing another sketch I'm excited about. We're doing a Sex in the City spoof, mm-hmm. Sex in the City 2060,
okay.
Where they're all in their 90s and they're still trying to bang hot young dudes at nightclubs.
Mm-hmm.
I'm playing Carrie Bradshaw.
Oh, well, that, okay. I saw you more as Cynthia Nixon, but okay.
Oh, I thought you were going to say Mr. Big, you motherfucker.
Well, if it's going to be the women.
Anyway, so we're doing that. I've been been doing a shit ton of road gigs. What else? I guess, just doing my thing. Been helping. I'm an angel. Do you know what I mean? I'm a fucking angel, Gootz.
Yeah, I know. You help out.
I help people in recovery, mentally ill people, mm-hmm. people with autism spectrum disorder.
And that's just at LOL.
And that's just at the LOL green room.
Yeah. People who can't leave abusive relationships.
People who can't leave their homes. People who can't leave LOL.
You're just
it's been an interesting year. I feel like I've grown as a person.
Not really.
So now I have even more perspective to offer. A more mature perspective on Spider-Man Far From Home.
That's why I didn't do this 2 years ago. I was like, you needed to grow as a person.
Right.
Before you could probably understand Spider-Man.
See the world, understand the universe, and now I could talk about this. Yeah.
Now, so when I started doing Aaron Haber's room, who, by the way, is super into NFTs.
He's one of my favorite people in comedy.
Do you follow him in anything?
No, I don't.
He's like the NFT king. He is...
He's rich?
I have a feeling. I have a feeling he's gonna run a scam that's gonna make him rich. I think that NFT thing is just anyway. That's a whole other podcast. But he did put me on a lot 10 years ago, and 10 years ago the hype was for the Avengers film. And I remember, I think this when we met, you would bark for him, but you were sitting there, and somebody's like, "Are you excited for Avengers?" And I'm like, "I don't give a fuck if they booked me at Madison Square Garden," which they didn't, by the way. I am not taking that gig the night of Avengers premiere. And you were like, "Oh, hello, I like the Avengers too."
That's such a dead-on impression.
Yeah, that was how you had your little lantern. And then we got to talk about comic books. So you've been into comic books. When did you get into them?
I've been into comics since I was, I guess, since I could understand what was going on in my house.
Okay.
And I was like, Jesus Christ, I need to escape from this hell. So I would say, like, I wasn't so into comics, I would shoplift comics.
Wow.
I shoplifted, like, Swamp Thing comics, like, whatever was at the 7-Eleven or what, you know, and I would shove it under my shirt. And then one time my father found out and he had me come back and give the comics back to the deli guy.
What comic book?
But I don't think it was a moral thing. I think it was because he didn't want me to be able to escape my hell.
He didn't want you to read.
What are you doing? He wanted to be an even worse parent. He's like, "You're reading? That's only gonna lead to problems.
You're reading about heroes and people that help one another? No, no, no,
no, no, no, no, no.
We must change this now.
Only villains for you."
Did you read about Stalin? How he murdered women for no reason.
Stalin should be your inspiration.
Yes.
So I was in the comics from like an early age, man. When I was in the South Bronx, I used to read comics, all through, like, they would give me lunch money and I would spend my lunch money on comic books. So there was a comic book store in Fairlawn, New Jersey called The Joker's Child, which is a really cool name for a comic store. The Joker's Child. And I would just fucking hang out there during my lunch and buy comics. And, I was probably a little creepy too. Because I was going through puberty, I was like, "Do you have any comic books with breasts?"
Oh, were you into Gen 13?
yeah, all that.
Oh,
you know?
Those characters. What happened to those girls? They were like on every cover of Wizard. I have so many Gen 13 comics. Somebody was helping me, and they're like, "Why did you buy?" Because they were hot chicks. And DC owns the rights to them. They have those characters, they're not even around anymore.
Yeah. Dude, comics used to be like softcore porn. It got to a point where it was like Skinamax on paper, you know?
Yeah. I would love if they had the balls to do Gen 13, but to make comic accurate costumes, especially Caitlin Fairchild's, where she just had her ass hanging out.
Dude, if they did that, you would have to have it would be like no more hot chicks. Like,
you can't have hot chicks anymore.
No. Everybody would be like overweight and like
Can I tell you, so like when they took away Lola Bunny's tits in the new Space Jam, right?
Yeah.
And they were like, this is what a normal girl looks like. I feel what they don't consider is like there's little girls who can't help it, but they get big tits. Like,
right.
They do. Like there's 12-year-olds, 13-year-olds that have massive boobies. And you're putting into these girls' heads that like you're not normal and like you're a whore. The skinny girl's like normal. That's what they're kind of putting in.
No, only Lizzo is normal.
Only Lizzo's normal. Yeah.
And only Lizzo can walk around in a thong.
Yeah, but if like you're like
with her tits hanging out.
Yeah, if you have your tits hanging out, you're
you gotta
you're
look like Lizzo. Yeah,
a
otherwise,
good woman. It's weird because it's like no, there's body types like Caitlin Fairchild.
Yeah.
Out there, but for some reason now we have to like demonize them.
Yeah. You're a piece of shit.
You're a piece of shit.
If you're at all decent looking, you're a piece of shit. You're supporting the patriarchy by being hot.
Yeah, it's really it's bizarre, but like yeah, like dude, the new comic books now, everyone's just so unfuckable. I mean, I'm
I think they're meant to be. They're meant to be that way.
They go. Yeah. They get mad if you try to make like somebody drew a sexy Miss Marvel, and that people got very angry. The new one, the Indian one.
Yeah, it's weird to me. Like, dude, why can't, and this should go both ways, like they're superheroes. It's like the same thing with models. Like these are people who should look extraordinary.
Yeah.
You know? I got into an argument with someone about about Batman, Robert Pattinson Batman, because supposedly
he
wouldn't work out. Mm-hmm. And a lot of people on the left are supporting that. They're like, "Yeah, you go Robert Pattinson.
No, Batman would have to work out.
I'm like, Batman would barely survive if he did work out.
I know.
Are you kidding me? If Batman walked out there trying to fight crime and he couldn't even do like one pull up, you know, they would beat the lift. He would survive. Like, he would be dead. The movie would be like 30 seconds. Batman was, you know, first day tried fighting crime. Oh, I guess that's the end of Batman, you know?
But you know what the other thing about Batman is that the other thing, well, that's the one thing about him. Like, but let's say he could survive. Like, who's Bruce Wayne in today's world? Maybe like Mark Zuckerman or Elon
Zuckerberg.
Musk. Zuckerberg, sorry. Zuckerman directed Naked Gun.
Well, it's funny. So we're seeing this now, right? So yeah. We're living in a reality where we have like a bunch of guys who, you know, Elon Musk, the richest man who's ever lived, mm-hmm. right? Mm-hmm. You have Zuckerberg and you have Amazon's guy.
Jeff Bezos,
okay. Right? Do any of those guys look like they in any reality, right?
No.
That they would ever have the slightest interest in fighting crime or doing good for the
world.
But
let's just say there was a mysterious man in a mask.
But I gotta tell you, if they do, you know, that's yeah. like that they're ready. They're like more like the perfect cover.
Yeah.
For Batman.
But let's just say let me give you a quick example. Yeah. Let's say like there was a mysterious man in a mask. There's like let's say there's a crime wave in LA, and there's a mysterious man in a bat suit. You know, get capturing criminals like rapists, drug dealers, and then somehow, like a few months in, we found out it was Jeff Bezos. Do you know the backlash?
Yeah,
that Jeff Bezos was going around improv neighborhoods.
They'd be like, "You fucking
beating the shit." You know,
they would be like, "You're like the Rich Rittenhouse."
Yeah,
you're like,
really,
you're,
you really,
you're
they
fucking,
really would be.
You're
yeah.
like Kyle Rittenhouse with money.
It's like, but because it's like, yeah, because like the argument they would make to Bruce Wayne now is like. Why couldn't you just like do social programs to improve the neighborhood?
Right, right.
Like if you put into place,
and they're right. He would have a bigger impact than being like just one guy in a costume,
yeah.
trying to take down criminals here, criminals there.
So
build a fucking you know sports facility.
And I don't even think like they would excuse it if there was like villains like Sinestro and Killer Croc.
Yeah.
Like, they would still get mad that Jeff Bezos...
Yeah, he should have tried to rehabilitate Killer Croc.
If he's like, but you don't understand, Sinestro...
Give Killer Croc a job.
Yeah,
give
Sinestro
him a chance.
Has a magic ring. Well, then why don't you teach Sinestro to use that magic ring to create jobs for people? I don't know, like...
Yeah.
Like, I have to use a bat plane to fight Doomsday. Like, no, Doomsday's an innocent animal that...
It would be far more believable with the wealthiest guys today mm-hmm. that they were, instead of superheroes, they were serial killers.
No, well,
that would be
Lex
far
Luther,
more believable.
Yeah, that's
yeah.
more believable, yeah.
Like, all these guys are much more like Lex Luthor than any
kind of ever, I gave this idea. I don't know if it was with you on the podcast, if it was somebody. If I ever did a new Superman movie, the first time you'd see Lex Luthor would be on Joe Rogan's podcast. And he'd be sitting with Tim Dillon and Joe Rogan, and they'd be saying how cool he is.
I would just make Tim Lex Luthor. I would make Tim
Andrew Schultz be a better
Tim
Lex
would
Luthor.
Be such a
Tim,
great
Tim,
villain
Tim
in, a,
would be
in a superhero movie.
A penguin. Tim would be a great penguin. Look, I'm not saying I smuggle the drugs in, Batman. I'm saying if you hit me, really? So I'm getting punched in the face by a billionaire. I'm just dealing with pot. And yes, it's okay for Jeff Bezos to break Bruce Wayne to break my arm. Is that what we're saying?
Tim would like would chastise. Tim would be horrified by all his co-actors, mm-hmm. and probably get fired in a day.
Yeah,
and it would be amazing.
But I think yeah, if I did Lex Luthor now, he'd be on Joe Rogan, and he'd be like just like smoking weed, shooting the shit.
Tim would give kryptonite to whoever the twink is playing Superman, and try to fuck him in the ass.
Jesus Christ.
He's like, Superman, can you move your fuck? Enough with the cape already, all right? I'm trying to sodomize you.
I would have Tim. Tim could be Otis. They brought back Otis.
Yeah, yeah, he'd be a good Otis. That,
he could
that's
be
true.
Otis. Like, Lex, what are we doing?
They don't put, you know what? Like, just here's a good segue to Spider-Man. You know, Spider-Man in the comics is some of the runs. He was actually pretty funny.
Yeah.
He's like a funny guy, you know? They've never had, and they've tried to make him funny, and they flopped every single time.
Well, it's because they made Star-Lord and Iron Man Spider-Man.
They made Star-Lord and Iron Man Spider-Man? What do you mean?
Like, Iron Man never told jokes. Iron Man was very cut and dry.
Oh, right, right.
He was kind of like Bones.
Yeah, yeah. Iron Man was never funny.
He was never funny.
He was so serious.
They'd be like, there's a problem. And then Iron Man would walk in the room. Okay, so Kang is over here. You go there, I go here, and we'll get him. Also, I'm going to go fuck Black Widow. Thanks, bye. And that would be Iron Man's dialogue in Avengers comic. And he'd be like, Quasar, attack him from the back. Like, he wouldn't crack jokes. And like, if someone cracked a joke, I'd be like, this is no time for jokes. Like, that was his whole fucking
And
book.
That makes sense for Iron Man. How many funny, how many hilarious multi-billionaires have you seen?
I know, but like, they made it.
He shouldn't be funny.
So they gave, when they started making Iron Man funny, it's like, well, you took Spider-Man's thing. Because you would have a team up with Iron Man, and Iron Man would be like, some science shit, and Spider-Man would be like, what are you talking about?
Ooh, yeah.
You
know?
But now Iron Man's funny, and Star-Lord is also kind of funny and a goof, and he's like a doofus who doesn't like really succeed in anything.
Right.
So you've given all this Spider-Man traits to everyone else.
Yeah.
And even Thor has a little bit of Spider-Man now.
Yeah, now everyone is funny except for Spider-Man.
Yeah. Yeah.
But they've all, like, Spider-Man should be funny. He should be funny.
Up in the Sam Raimi movie, they didn't have him talk that much. And somebody said, how come he doesn't talk that much? And they were like, oh, we just think it's unreal.
Because Tobey Maguire is annoying, let's be honest.
But also they were like, well, I think he said something like, we wanted to be more stoic, like Batman.
Oh,
like,
get out of here. That's not the character.
Yeah.
That's not the character. Yeah.
Because I think if they started off with him being funny in the first movie, I don't think they would have made Iron Man funny.
Yeah, I guess you're right.
But they were like, well, they're not making Spider-Man funny in these fucking films, so we might as well make Iron Man funny.
They tried to make him a little more funny with Andrew Garfield.
And that was horrible.
This
is probably the funniest Spider-Man. He's not even that funny.
He's the funniest, but he's not really that funny.
You know who's actually the Peter Parker in Spider-Verse was probably the truest Peter Parker.
Yeah, that was the best. That was the best Spider-Man
and the hero version. That is the best Spider-Man movie, actually. Decided last week. But before we get into the Far From Home, because I got a lot to say about that, the MCU, No Way Home, we got a lot to talk about. You have two. The reason why I had you on is because you have had two amazing experiences with Spider-Man. This should actually be the basis for Spider-Man versus Venom, both of your stories.
Yeah,
about Spider-Man. Do you want to tell them, and then we'll talk about this movie?
All right. Remind me which ones.
One at the party.
Yeah.
You used to dress up like Spider-Man for the parties.
Right, right.
And then there's also the one about your father-in-law when he was dying.
Oh, God. Yeah. Oh, my God. Wow, you're bringing up some real trauma podcast.
Listen, it's Spider-Man season.
Oh, God. I haven't thought about this in a while.
You've had adventures with Spider. You're one of his amazing friends.
I am one of his amazing friends. Yeah. So I used to work... I used to work for this costume party company. And it was probably the lowest.
Sassy ran it, right?
I don't want to name any names.
Okay, sorry.
I worked for a couple.
Sheba Mason ran it.
Anyway. I worked for a couple. Let's just say I worked for a couple. Mm-hmm. One of them was one of the lowest rung. I think like ex-convicts. That was like your work release program.
Well, she's
definitely
above. What was that?
Imagine? I'm not saying it was. I'm not saying what company. Okay. Yeah, but I was a bunch of companies.
I consider her a headliner. Uncrowned, but you go ahead.
So, when I first got it, I was like such a superhero geek. I was like, it'll be fun, whatever. I'll be Spider-Man, you know, and I'll work out. I want to look good, you know. I don't want to look like fucking sad dad bod Spider-Man.
Well, now you can get away with it because of Into the Spider-Verse. But
right now, I could be fucking Peter Parker, you know.
You can wear the trench coat.
Yeah. Like, yeah. Oh, totally. The trench coat.
That makes it.
Yeah, pedophile Peter Parker with the trench coat. Flasher, fucking Subway Flasher Peter Parker.
My spider sense is tingling. There's my web shooter.
Jesus, why is that guy masturbating on the on the D train right now? And he's wearing a Spider-Man costume. So I fucking. The costumes were horrible. In the beginning, the job was fun, you know, like the first couple of times. And I was like in the best shape of my life, you know? So I was like running, like I would, you know, like I'm, you know, I always like do too much, right?
Yeah, you would run a story.
I'd be like running around. I'd be like, oh my God, I got another gig. Oh fuck, I gotta be Spider-Man in 10 minutes. So I'd like put on the costume and be running, you know, to like this house somewhere like in deep Bronx. Mm-hmm. And like people would be like honking, Spidey, go Spidey, you know? People love Spider-Man.
They
you
do.
Know? They do. So, So eventually it fell off the rails, right? Mm. Eventually I was like, oh God, working out's a bitch. Fuck this, you know? So I got fat. So I was like fat Spider-Man, you know? but first, like, so the costumes are like so fucking tight. Like Spider-Man costume, when you watch all those costumes, they do so much stuff. Like those guys have to really starve themselves.
Yeah.
You know? Because it's a very unforgiving costume. And also the crotch. They do like all this like weird stuff to cover up the bulge that you don't even notice. They have like special, like specially designed cups.
But I think that's why in these movies, the Spider-Man actors are constantly taking off their mask so they can be like, no, I worked out. You're going to fucking see me.
Yeah. They want the credit.
Because I guarantee you, if they never took...
Screen time and credit.
I would never want Spider-Man to take off his mask if I was making a movie, but I guarantee you the actors are like, no, fuck this.
Yeah.
If they did take off the mask, people would be like, that's just a stunt man.
I gotta tell you, it's so sweaty. Mm-hmm. It's so fuck. You sweat your balls off.
Yeah.
But they try to make it look like, oh, there's a hint of a bulge, but we don't want to really make it look like a human penis.
We want to be kind of intrigued.
Yeah, like there's something there, but you know. So I didn't realize that. I remember the first time, my first Spider-Man gig, I put on the costume, like, you know, and I'm wearing underwear, and you can still see, like, my penis in great detail.
Your spider cock.
Like you can see the veins. you can see where I did not shave. You know,
wow.
It's like, well, Spider-Man's got a bush. He's very, you know, very 70s.
That would be a good advertisement for Manscaped.
It would, yeah. Mm-hmm.
My spider bush.
My spider. So I fucking I had this gig and I had to like race over there. And I, you know, and I'm like, oh, fuck, you know, I'm going to leave extra early this time. Right. So I got there. I'm like super early. I'm like, fucking, yeah, I'm finally early for this gig. I could relax. I'm going to get some food. I'm starving. I got like, you know, a bunch of burritos. And then the burrito like sauce, whatever, drips on my costume. Now my costume's like all stained.
You ate in that costume.
I know. I ate in the costume. Right. The costume's all stained. And then I call them up like, hey, guys, I'm here early. They're like, oh, where are you? I'm like, I'm in the townhouse community. They're like, what are you talking about? I'm like, what do you mean, the townhouse? They're like, we don't live in a townhouse. I'm like, what? Like, yeah, no. And then I realized, like, oh, I put in the wrong town, I guess, into the... And they're like, dude, you're like over 2 hours away. You're going to be late for my kid's party. Like, what the fuck? I'm like, oh, no. So, like, I race over there, right? I hit traffic, so I'm like 3 hours late. So I get to this, no parking, I'm running, it's the dead of summer, fucking over 100 degrees.
Jesus.
I show up to the party crazy late, right? Mm-hmm. Everyone's miserable. Mm-hmm. Everyone's so miserable because they're going to have Spider-Man for the whole party. They open the door and the guy's like, who the fuck are you? And I'm like, I'm Spider-Man. You're like, you look homeless. Why are there so many stains? Like, you have, what is that? That's green. Like, you have, like, what is
that? I was fighting the lizard.
Yeah, I was fighting the lizard in a Mexican restaurant.
So, there's green blood all over me.
So, yeah, me and the lizard got into it at Chipotle. So, I got, like, huge armpit stains, you know? It's so bad. I'm like, dude, just get in here, you know? And everyone's just, like, staring me down, you know? And I'm trying to, like, play music, but like I got the Spidey gloves on, so it won't work with my phone. So I'm like, hang on, I gotta take off the. So it's all like uncoordinated. Like, can you do something? Can you like flip? And I'm like, I just had back surgery.
So are you just like standing there?
I am literally the worst Spider-Man of all time, right? Like, I just stand. I don't flip. I don't what you want from me. Like, try to flip, man. Come on. So I'm like, dude, I'm really in pain. You're like, dude, you're late. We're paying good money. You gotta try to flip. So I try. So I'm like, all right, guys, here goes nothing. So I try to do like a tumble or something. And I just end up rolling on the floor like I'm trying to put out a fire on my body or something.
And you have the mask on, right?
Yeah, and then I have the mask on, and then I get up, and that's even sadder because I got like lint and like like dog hair, and everything's on me. And they're like, Jesus Christ! And the parents get to fight. They're like, did you research this company? Like, what the fuck? Who is this guy? You know? And the kids are like, oh no, mommy and daddy are fighting again. You know? So I think my Spider-Man appearance is the first to lead to a divorce and probably a beating.
Jesus.
Yeah. So, what are you gonna say?
Didn't you like make out with a mom as Spider-Man?
Oh, that was awesome. Okay. Let me tell you, there's women have superhero fetishes.
They do.
They really do. Batman was my number one.
Oh, when really? I dress that, up as well, Batman, the rich, the Batman is a whole thing.
Yeah.
More so than Spider-Man. Yeah.
They love. I had one woman. She wanted me to keep the Batman cowl on while hooking up with her.
Jesus.
Which is rough because like it gets in your eyes and stuff.
Yeah.
It takes a lot of focus. but Spider-Man. So okay. So the next. So I figured out. You know, all right, I got to cover my dick because you can see everything, and you know. So I got an athletic cup, and that was problematic because. You know, I got it and it was like two. It was like really big. It was like really. It's like it made it worse, right?
It made it like, but Jesus, what are you, Spider-Man's package?
It was like fucking Mandingo, yeah.
Okay.
So I will go to this party. I'm like, well, it's better than fucking them seeing, you know, the quality of my circumcision, you
yeah,
know.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So I popped it in, and I get to the party and I could see like, you know, they're like what the fuck. Did that guy stuff his pants? You know, is that his real dick? Like, it was my dick became the focus of this party, and then everyone's wasted, and I'm about to leave, and one of the mothers is like, "Hey, hang on a second. You want to just you know chill over here?" I'm like, "All right," and then she was just wasted. She's like, "Let's go into the bathroom," and so we're in the bathroom, and she reached down and she was like feeling the cup, and she's like, "Oh, that's just a cup. That's not your dick." And she's like, and she said, that's a disappointment. Mm-hmm. And I'm like, that's the disappointing part? Not the fact that you're about to fuck?
You fuck a fake Batman?
Fuck a fake Spider-Man.
Oh, you're Spider-Man.
at your kid's birthday party?
Jesus Christ. Where was this? Was this in the Bronx? Or?
No. This is Brooklyn.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Some hipster moms.
A hipster mom, yeah.
Hipster mom, Jesus.
Yeah.
And then let's, so now tell the story about your father-in-law in the Spider-Man comics.
Oh, so, so, oh, God. All right, so this is like early on, when I was an open micer, I was, you know, with this... With
You're
this
married.
Woman, yeah, I was married. All right, let's say I was married. And before I feel bad, I'm not going to name any names, all right? Yeah. And I'll say this. She was beautiful. She is beautiful, you know, and had a perfect vagina, okay?
She's my number one fan. She listens to every episode.
Excellent vagina.
I'm sure she'll hear this.
And number one, yeah. She loves comic book podcasts.
When she heard the Carell episode, she was like, I'm hooked. She went back.
Yeah. So I was an idiot. I didn't know what the fuck I was doing comedy. So I was just trying. I was like, let me try to write some dark jokes about my life and people in it. So I wrote some horrible stuff about her and her family, which I didn't mean. You know, I didn't mean it. So I wrote some stuff about them all being too ugly to be in pictures and, you know, her having a huge pussy, which she did not have. She had a great pussy.
Okay.
And how, like, I hated her sister. And I didn't hate
Who
her
you
sister.
Loved.
I actually loved her sister. But I was, like, playing it up. You know, the sister, I think, hated me. And I was trying to play that up and whatever. And, you know, I made fun of the voices and all this stuff, you know, because they had, like, these, like, Jersey accents. Yeah. I said something like, you know, her voice is so bad that it gave me erectile dysfunction or something.
Jesus. Okay.
So like, oh, I can't. This is like too mean. I can't do this ever on stage. Let me put it away. Maybe this will be like roast jokes one day or something. You know.
Yeah.
So I'm like, where can I hide them? You know what? I'll hide them in my comics. I got these boxes and boxes of comics. I'll just slip them in one of my comics. But put it in my Spider-Man comic. I'm like, she's never gonna fucking read this. No one's gonna read this. No one. You know, who's gonna read my comics?
Yeah, yeah.
You know. So, okay. Fast forward. We're getting divorced. We're like in the middle of a divorce. I'm in New York. She's somewhere in another state. And I'm like, yeah, my comic's back down there. I'll get him later. Whatever. No big deal.
Yeah.
I'll figure it out. Her father is diagnosed with cancer. Mm-hmm. He's in the hospital. It looks pretty bleak, pretty stark. And she goes to him. This is what I find out later. She goes and she's like, can I do anything for you? You know, I know you're in a lot of pain. This is horrible for you. You're stuck here in the hospital. Anything at all? What can I do to help make it better for you? He's like, oh, I need a distraction. You know, I've always been a fan of comics. I love Spider-Man comics. And I know Allan left some. Can you bring some of Allan's comics? Maybe I could read them. So she brings him the comics.
Mm-hmm.
He gets to the comic where the piece of paper falls out and he reads it. And it's all about how he's too ugly to be in photos. one of his daughter's voice, the voice
and
of one of his
and
daughters.
Huge pussy. She has a huge pussy.
And yeah, one of his
don't
daughter,
forget about the massive pussy.
And the massive pussy. Yeah. So the voice gives, you know, I can't get my dick hard because the way they talk and the pussy is huge. And he's like, I'm going to kill this guy. And he was like, it created such a fire within him that I feel, and he, the silver lining is he had a full recovery.
Full recovery.
The doctors were like, this is a miracle. And I'm telling you, it's because
he wants to kill you.
He wanted to kill me.
Yeah. Yeah, well, I would have been pissed. Looking back, I would have pissed my wife because those could be valuable comic books. Like, just go buy him a trade paper package at fucking Midtown Comics.
Right?
Why do you give him my comics? What if, like, she gave him the first appearance of Venom or something?
Yeah, in the hospital.
And this guy's got cancer juice all over it.
The cancer juice, the Jello, whatever, you know, apple juice and those things, you know?
It's like, yeah, so I would have been like, who are you to give away vintage comics? That's not like...
I know.
Just go buy a couple of new issues, you cheap bitch.
Dude, she's not a bitch. She's a wonderful person with a great vagina.
Listen.
But I just wanted to say... Like, you lost your comic with Miles Morales. Dude, I lost my entire collection because of that.
She got so mad, yeah.
Yeah, and let me tell you, it did not do me any favors for the divorce.
No. I can imagine.
It was a very friendly, amicable divorce until that point.
And then she was like, Allan Finn, you are a piece of idiot.
Yeah.
And you're like, well, I can't argue with that.
Or Fuks, whatever.
Whatever. Okay, well, hey. Yeah. But now... Now that we've done,
now we're here.
Now we're here. We've done. You have a history with Spider-Man. He's caused you a lot of pain.
Yes.
In fact, this is a better origin story than Mysterio or Vulture in the new universe. But whatever
it is.
But now we're gonna talk about Far From Home. Allan, you just rewatched it. I just rewatched it for the first time in 2 years. What'd you think? What do you think?
Oh, I think they needed more cast members from Curb Your Enthusiasm. Why stop at Leon? Why not Susie Essman calling everyone a cunt?
You're a cunt, Spider-Man. You know what? She would have been a good Aunt May, though.
She would have been a great Aunt May.
That's who she'd be.
Way more realistic, fucking Queens Aunt May. What do you think your Queens Aunt May would look like?
Yeah,
she'd be like that big fat lady who owns Bagels and Brew over here.
Mm-hmm.
You know, like where the fuck you going? What are you doing? She would have much more of an edge. Yeah. She wouldn't be like some hot Marissa Tomei. How many hot Marissa Tomeis do you see around here who are aunts in Queens?
I mean, like, there's some moms that are hot.
But not like Marissa Tomei. It's ridiculous.
Yeah, well, that's insane. Yeah.
So, but yeah, they should have Susie Essman. They could have had Larry David. He should have been the Vulture.
Well, yeah. Well, that was the original plan, you know.
And
the studio was like, no fucking way.
Larry David was supposed to, and then Howard Stern, they were talking about the Vulture.
Well,
they really want to go super
Sam
Jew.
Sam Raimi wanted either Larry David or John Malkovich.
Yeah, well, that's a pretty wide range.
And they made him put Venom. I think his original plan was Larry David, and they were like, no. And he was like, what about John Malkovich? And they were like, no, Venom. Because Malkovich is a little bit more threatening.
Yeah.
Then Larry David would have been like, what? Spider-Man? What's the problem?
I love all these characters. They're supposed to be elderly,
mm-hmm.
like near like hospice age. And they're all like, all right, let's see. So elderly. So we need somebody who's like has one foot in the grave to play Peter Parker's aunt. Marissa Tomei, she's 50.
That's okay. How it is now. Like they don't cast ugly. They don't cast ugly people. They cast good looking people and put prosthetics on them.
Michael Keaton plays a character who's supposed to be ridiculously elderly.
Yeah. Well, now he's young. Yeah.
Yeah.
Real quick, I thought this was a very good MCU movie. I thought this was a very good follow up to Endgame. It was not the greatest Spider-Man movie. If you took out Spider-Man and put in Ironheart, the female Iron Man, it would have been the same movie.
Yeah.
It just made, and then, like, let's say you made Mary Jane Ironheart and just made change Peter Parker, and he's the love interest, and Zendaya is Ironheart. It's the same fucking movie. It's like Kid Iron Man, basically.
Yeah.
Which is not what Spider-Man is. And I get that's what he has to be that way in MCU because of how they introduced him and everything, but, like, yeah, it was a fine movie. It just nothing really reminds, and the action scenes are incredible, especially the final battle in London.
Yeah,
but nothing really reminds me of Spider-Man.
You know, it's like It's like when a sitcom runs out of ideas, mm-hmm. and like we know
we'll go on a
European vacation. Yeah, yeah, we'll take them to they'll go on a whatever. They'll find a, like France, whatever country is offering the best tax incentives.
Yeah,
Australia.
I get like every now and then they would take Spider-Man out of his element just to mix it up in the comics, but like you still have not. They haven't done a streetwise like Spider-Man used to be very street level, but now they have like moved to different universes and all this other, even the comics. They have never done a street level Spider-Man movie yet, and they already have him going to Europe. So you haven't nailed New York yet, and you haven't running around Europe with Nick Fury.
Yeah, it's ridiculous. Spider-Man should be like destitute, freaking out about his finances. Friendly neighborhood Spider-Man.
Yeah,
not like international jet setter. Globetrotter. Yeah,
build his suit I get what they're trying to do with him being Iron Man or something, like being the heir apparent to the Iron Man. And so I get to like a different story, but like I don't know. It's just like, so then what is Ironheart's story going to be?
The same thing. The recycle. What do you mean?
Okay. Well, yeah, but it was good. And then Zendaya, I think her character's good. That's not Mary Jane. I would have been better if they had called her Felicia Hardy.
Yeah.
Or Gwen. Or not Gwen. I guess Gwen always has to be white. I would have had her be a different name. There's a lot of other love interests. She's not Mary Jane.
Yeah.
Nothing about her is Mary Jane.
No, dude, I don't know. I like the action scenes. The Mysterio stuff.
They nailed
Mysterio.
Because that's a very hard character to do, because his powers, he does it with like special effects, but like you're doing that in the real world.
Yeah.
It's kind of weird, but like it makes sense in the way they do in this movie. He kind of has to have Stark Tech to do this shit.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Like growing up, I never thought that's a character they could do live action without it looking ridiculously cheesy. But they did it.
They did it. He doesn't look cheesy.
No, it looks good.
I don't know if you can see what you can't see because the podcast audio.
Yeah.
You can see that is a very comic accurate movie costume.
Yeah,
and it's kind of insane that was it's wild to me. That's the one costume they did not change.
Right,
but they've changed all the Eternals costumes.
Yeah.
And everyone else's costume. But they're like Mysterio, leave that alone.
Yeah, no, but, they nailed Mysterio. Mm-hmm. I didn't like, again, with the comedy, like J.B. Smoove, who's a very funny guy.
Yeah.
But it was just like, guys, stop. Like, come on. It's taking away from it.
I don't like what they did with Flash.
I don't like Flash.
I didn't like Flash. That's stupid. Both movies.
Yeah.
I like Ned and Betty. I thought Ned's very good.
Yeah. But Ned's going to have to lose a ton of weight,
he
right?
Did.
Even more. I don't know.
Oh, because he... Well, I don't know. Well, that's not really what Ned was like in the comics, though.
Yeah, yeah.
And neither... That's also what Betty was. Betty wasn't like that in the comics.
Okay.
Ned was... Ned is actually based on Genki, who is Miles Morales' best friend in the comics. Miles Morales has a big, fat Asian friend.
Okay.
Named Genki. And they just gave it to Peter Parker.
Yeah.
And changed the name to Ned.
Yeah.
And Ned's a skinny guy. Ned's a reporter who falls in love with Betty Bryant.
Mm.
Betty Brant, whatever the fuck her name is. But yeah, like, I really like the way the movie starts. The one thing to...
You like the way it started? I had mixed feelings. Because on the one hand, I'm like, okay, this is... that part I thought was kind of funny, actually.
With the shitty, like, high school...
They did a good job. But it's also, like, tonally... Like we just went through all of that with Avengers, mm-hmm. the blip, the snapping of the fingers, mm-hmm. and it was played for like this like heavy drama, grief counseling. Like half of like Endgame was like grief counseling.
Well, they did say that they had to retake the school year, so I think it's a year after Endgame.
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't think it's right.
But
after
then it
Endgame.
Just like became like, oh, this is like wacky, yeah.
So in this sitcom. Marvel timeline that I follow. WandaVision, Captain America and the Falcon, Loki, Eternals, Shang-Chi all take place before this movie.
Oh, really? Okay.
Yeah. So I guess, remember, Captain America and Falcon, they're trying to deal with where they're going to put people.
Right.
Which is what Aunt May. But I think like by the time this movie comes out. The other thing I also think is I don't think the people who made this movie, I don't think they told them exactly. So I know when they were making Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D., a lot of times they didn't know exactly what was going to happen in the movie. They just told the writers, Hydra's actually been controlling S.H.I.E.L.D. the entire time. But they don't tell, they didn't tell them anything else about Winter Soldier.
Right.
So they kind of have to like act like they know what happened in that movie. But they, I also think in this movie, they didn't 100% know exactly what Spider-Man was going to do at Endgame. Because at one point, they have Iron Man. You could have saved me. Why didn't you? No, no, he couldn't. Spider-Man could not have saved him.
Yeah.
He took the, what was Spider-Man supposed to do? Take the Infinity Gauntlet? I'll snap for you. You know, like, so like, I think they didn't really know how Iron Man died in that movie. They right. just kind of like made it vague so they could film their movie.
I liked it overall. You mm-hmm. know, I like the drone stuff, you know, like, I guess I could sort of buy it. Mm-hmm. It doesn't quite make the cliffhanger doesn't quite make sense.
Well,
because
he takes the mask off every 3 seconds.
Yeah, it takes a mask. I mean, how does someone not caught him on camera with the mask? Like every, even like in the beginning of the movie, he's in the kitchen. He's you know, takes the mask. Like, dude, what are you not? You're not in a fucking private room here. What are you doing?
Nick Fury knows. He tells everyone he works.
Yeah.
Like, why does this Dimitri guy know? How am I supposed to? I don't know this fucking guy. He knows my secret identity.
Yeah.
Like, a lot of people know. So,
but also with the drones, you know, like people were there. People saw mm-hmm. what was going on. They saw Spider-Man fighting with that. No one noticed Spider-Man fighting with Mysterio. Like, what did everyone watching? Those were huge battles.
We had the attack on the Capitol, and they filmed it, and people still think.
Yeah, that's true. That is true. Everybody was a crisis actor during the Mysterio fight.
The other thing is, so like they've got to explain this in No Way Home, because why would? Here's a really fast solution. That fucking Skrull who fucked up Talos. Shows up as Spider-Man, takes the mask, reveals like he's like Bob from accounting, and Peter Parker stands next to him and goes, I'm not Spider-Man, look. Because they don't know about Skrulls on
Spider-Man. Oh, yeah, yeah.
So why couldn't you just do that and be like, I'm not Spider-Man, sorry. Why do you have to go to Doctor Strange and rip open the multiverse? I guess maybe they'll have a scene with Talos. We don't know that yet.
Really quick, the new trailer that came out.
Yeah.
With, so... For Spider-Man?
No Way Home.
No Way Home.
Yeah.
What does it mean to Scooby-Doo this?
Oh,
Doctor Strange keeps saying Scooby-Doo this.
Oh, the Scooby-Doo gang would like solve the problem. He meant Scooby-Doo it, like fix the problem.
He said it twice.
Well, he said it's Scooby-Doo this crap. And they're like, say please. And he goes, please screw Scooby-Doo.
But I don't understand why a man who's around 50 years old would be yelling Scooby-Doo this
Josh
crap.
Because Josh Whedon has ruined screenwriting.
It's just so stupid.
Everyone wants to talk like they're on The Office.
A guy, a doctor, he's a highly educated doctor. What highly educated doctor walk in a room, Scooby-Doo this crap!
He needs
heart surgery, Scooby-Doo!
I get why you would want Peter Parker to solve the problem. Why are you asking Mary Jane and this fat kid?
Yeah, what are they? Well, I'm so irritated. Non-powered people should not be involved in any of this. They should be hiding under their couches while this is going down.
Why don't you call? Isn't Wong best friends with Abomination?
Yeah,
why don't you call the Abomination and Shang-Chi and the sister with the hand? I don't know. Why don't you?
I hate all the non-powered characters: Black Widow, Hawkeye. Shang-Chi's friend, Awkwafina. Awkwafina's involved now? What is Awkwafina going to do?
Did you see Eternals yet?
What? No, I haven't seen it yet.
What a piece of shit.
Yeah.
What a piece of shit.
You told me, yeah.
I know like so many people who, like you and Evan Williams, who rush to Marvel films and Andrew Lee, have not seen this yet. Even my friend and her kids were like, yeah, we're just going to wait for Disney Plus for this one.
Yeah.
And
dude, and I've rushed every single Marvel movie. I'm such a fan.
I'll tell you the mistake they're making.
Yeah.
People want, and Disney gets like this. If Disney can't make the maximum money off something,
yeah,
they kind of bury it. It doesn't matter what it is. It doesn't matter what it is or how much people like it. If they don't think they make, they just go move away from it. And they did that with the X-Men. And I think for years they did with X-Men and Fantastic Four. They didn't have the rights to them, but now they do. Here's the thing. And people want the Fantastic Four and the X-Men. That's what people want. That is the most interesting thing story you have left to tell.
Yeah.
It's not the Eternals. And I think people are starting... I know I am. I'm getting annoyed with... Guys, you're not even hinting that you're going to do anything with the X-Men. The cartoon is not enough. The cartoon, yeah, they just announced... Yeah.
Well, that's a stepping stone. The cartoon's a stepping stone.
Yeah, you have to jump on this. Yeah. And you have to, like... Silver Surfer, Galactus, Doctor Doom. This is what we want to see.
Right.
We don't want to see the Eternals.
They got cocky with Guardians of the Galaxy. Yeah. They're like, we could turn this obscure comic no one's heard of into, you know,
but
movie
the Guardians
gold.
Of the Galaxy, like the book that came out in 2008, was a great book. You had a lot to pull from. Eternals has never had a good book.
I remember reading it and I thought I liked it. I don't know. It wasn't the most fun book. But it was I liked it. Some
the movie's
the concepts.
Just miserable. Yeah. It's one of the most miserable. I was angry. It was so fun. It doesn't feel like a Marvel movie.
Yeah.
And I do think sometimes Marvel movies are a little bit too silly. Like they're a little bit too like jokey.
Right.
But like there's got to be a balance between being bored. Like it doesn't mean I think they think when we're not silly, it's boring because that's what Eternals was. There's gonna be a balance between boring and being goofy.
Dude, how weird is it now that the funniest person in Marvel movies is Thor?
Yeah.
Like what? Which is great. Mm-hmm. I mean, that's really still like one of the best Marvel movies is Ragnarok.
Yeah.
And probably the most Marvel of the Marvel movies, you know?
Yeah, no, you're right. You're right.
One more thing about Far From Home. I just also, you're speaking about like non-powered people having outsized roles.
Yeah.
Enough with Happy. Enough.
Oh, yeah. Well,
it's enough with Happy.
I think something happens to him.
Why is Happy flying the jet and all this stuff and... He's like trying to save these three high school friends of Peter.
They really should just call these three movies Marvel Team Up.
It's just so annoying. Dude, if you're Zendaya with like your dumb high school friends and this middle-aged guy named Happy is like, come with me. Come on, come here. I got a jet. Come on. You'd be like, dude, fucking. I'd be like, yo, like Amber Alert, like pedophile, like somebody. You'd be like, freak out. Like, dude, fucking get away from me. Who the hell are you, you know?
Yeah. It's weird how Happy has become Spider-Man's butler. It's like
he really is. Yeah.
Yeah. It's like,
why? Why is he his butler? Why is he hanging out with these high school kids?
Because Tony. I guess.
Why
Tony
is anybody hanging out with these high school kids?
Tony Stark told him to. before he died, and also he left. How did Tony know that Spider-Man's going to come back to life?
Dude, dying people say a lot of shit to people who are still going to be around.
Iron Man
doesn't mean you have to stick to it.
Iron Man dies 3 minutes after Spider-Man comes back to life. So what did Iron Man say to Happy? Listen, in the event that Spider-Man comes back to life, even though he died in my arms,
right?
I wanted to have these glasses.
Yeah,
you know, but boss, he's dead. No. There might be a situation where he comes back to life and then I die immediately after.
Right.
So I'm going to need you to hand him these glasses.
I need you to hand him one of the deadliest weapons on Earth.
Yeah, if he comes back to life.
If he comes back. He'd be like, wait, he's not even a sophomore in high school. Doesn't matter. I want him. With great power comes great responsibility. He needs to learn the responsibility of having basically nuclear weapons at his disposal immediately.
Yes.
It's insane.
And yeah. And like yeah, and it's like okay, all right. Well, what if he doesn't come back to life? Give it to Scott Lang. Okay, bye. I don't know. Give it to the Rocket Raccoon if Spider-Man doesn't come back to life.
Wait, are there any other 15-year-olds I give these glasses to? It's ridiculous.
Can we
give these weapons of mass destruction to a high school kid? It's nuts. It's so stupid.
Yeah, but and then the kid just hands it to fucking Mysterio. I thought Jake Gyllenhaal was great as Mysterio.
He was a good Mysterio. Because now whenever I watch him, I'm like, I'm looking for like those asshole moments that Taylor Swift sings about. I see it. Okay.
I see it in this movie. I see him as the type of guy who
he
would
was probably like that with Taylor.
He probably like, Taylor, I don't want to break your heart, but God damn it, you pissed me off.
Right.
Unleash the drones.
Yeah. Those are the faces he would make when he was yelling at her for not swallowing his load.
The other cool thing I liked, because I think little things like this make you pay attention to every movie,
yeah,
is that the guy that got yelled at in Iron Man 1 is one of the henchmen for Mysterio.
Oh, really? Oh, right,
remember
right.
They cut, Tony Stark made this out of scrap metal in the desert!
Every supervillain is just like a disgruntled Tony Stark employee.
Yeah.
Yeah.
but like, I did like the fact, because like, oh, that was, because then...
Meanwhile, Tony wasn't even that mean. No, he was just like... He just was like, you know, like, I don't want to deal with you. I'm not gonna go.
Dude, I've dealt with some
on a rooftop.
Assholes. Tony is not one of them.
I'll
tell you that much. I think little stuff like that, it rewards people for paying attention. It makes people want to see everything, because it's like, wow, like, I forgot, but I remember that scene. I think it's smart to do shit like that every now and then.
No, that was good. That was good. Yeah, overall it was good. I would take out the JB's, even though I love JB Smooth. I would take him out with the teacher.
By the way, he's in this one, I heard.
Oh, he's in this again?
Yeah.
Oh, God.
I do think that the kids, I hope the kids aren't like, I'm okay with Zendaya and Ned being around, but I hope Flash isn't also like making his videos and like Betty. Like they're trying to make they're trying to make their friends a thing, and I'm like, less of the friends. Less of the friends.
Yeah.
Less of the friends. You know what? Like, can we just have less of the fucking, you know, let's more of Aunt May and her nice little ass. I don't want to see these
love
kids.
I love Marissa Tomei. Yeah. I gotta tell you.
Let's see.
I'm still like, I'd be just as creepy as happy. I'd be like, Peter, I know you got to go deal with Mysterio, but what's Aunt May doing?
Yeah.
Yeah. Where is she? I wouldn't even be like, I'm trying to like, start trying to save these kids. I'm like, I'll be trying to fuck Aunt May.
What's the funniest thing about this is that they've desexualized every other character but Aunt May.
I know. She's the only one.
They've made her like completely, like everyone now wants to fuck Aunt May.
And they're like all pissed. Like, why is Peter pissed at fucking Happy trying to get with Aunt May?
I think he has to deal with this.
Like, dude, think about what Aunt May would be dealing with, you know, if she were, like, a real person here in Queens, the kind of scumbags we're trying to bang her. Happy?
Yeah.
Happy's probably got a ton of money. He's a good guy. Let him, like, fucking make him your stepdad, dude. You're going to only do worse.
I had an idea for, like, Spider-Man 3. Because remember Otto Octavius fucks Aunt May in the comics, right?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. So you cast Anthony Michael Hall.
Oh,
as Otto Octavius, but then you do flashbacks.
Yeah,
because you de-age him. Because when he was up for, they were thinking about him for Spider-Man when he made Breakfast Club and shit.
He would have been good.
He would have been good. So you,
Michael Keaton would have been better.
So you, okay, yes.
I'm not Michael Keaton. Michael J. Fox.
Michael J. Fox would have been.
He would have been great. Yeah.
But you flash back to them in high school. You de-age everybody, and then you reveal like Uncle Ben is like either Emilio Estevez or Corey, not Corey Feldman. Who was the other one? Like, maybe like, did he? What was the guy he lost Molly Ringwald to in Pretty in Pink?
Oh, I know. I know.
Or 16 Candles.
Yeah, I know that guy.
You have
yeah.
that guy. You de-age that guy, and he's Uncle Ben.
Right.
And now he comes back, and he's like a bitter. So you make it like he's Peter Parker. Dr. Oct would be Peter Parker gone wrong.
Yeah.
And he's obsessed with Aunt May. He's like stalking her. And he buddies up with Peter to get close to Aunt May. She rejects him, and then he becomes Doc Ock. And
yeah.
Like, I thought that'd be kind of cool.
They were going for a little bit of an 80s vibe. Because Spider-Man would work as like a John Hughes type movie.
You know what? Like, if you did a period piece with Spider-Man in the 80s, it would totally fucking work.
That'd be great.
Yeah.
And
if you could like use that technology to de-age, like you de-age Charlie Sheen, fucking Judd Nelson, right?
Yeah.
Molly Ringwald, you de-age all these people and make that movie. And Michael J. Fox, you get him to like stop stuttering. You'd have an incredible Spider-Man.
Because
movie.
Spider-Man, a big part of the Spider-Man character until, you know, until the Internet jittering. Revolution. The what?
The jittering that Michael J. Fox does?
Exactly, yeah. You that would be great when he's fighting villains. They would just like start feeling sorry for him.
Well, Spider-Man
they'd be like, dude, I can't fight you. This looks horrible for me. I can't. Let me just give you money to your charity and just call it a day. I just, you know, what the fuck was I saying? What were we talking about? The
80s Spider-Man.
80s Spider-Man. Mm-hmm. So he's a photographer for the Daily Bugle. Mm-hmm. That was like a big part of the character.
Yeah.
It's like you go around taking photos of Spider-Man. No one can figure out, how are you getting all these photos of Spider-Man? No one fucking pieced it together, you know? And then he would try to make money, pay his rent with those photos. That would be great for an 80s Spider-Man now with CGI, you know?
Yeah, well,
You can't do it. He can't be a photographer now for any newspaper or news site. It doesn't work. He can't be, you know what I mean? Like, how do you make that a part of the character?
I have a feeling, based on the kind of rumors I heard, No Way Home kind of resets everything at the end.
Yeah, yeah.
Where he's more the traditional Spider-Man.
Because he probably loses the suit and is the Iron Man.
I think he loses the Iron Man connection.
Yeah, yeah.
Here's the other thing. I think this is what everything's leading to. And I think this is why. Did you see Let There Be Carnage?
Yeah.
You saw the after credits where now he's in the MCU?
Yeah, yeah.
I think the reason why they did that is, number one, I think they want to do Venom versus Spider-Man, but set in the MCU so they can, I don't know, have like fucking Shang-Chi show up.
It might be Venom versus Miles Morales, because Tom Holland, I don't know if he's holding out for more money, but it sounds like he's done.
No, he's not done. Daniel Craig said the same thing, and then he was fine.
Yeah, yeah.
No, this is
he's going to be 50-year-old
Robert
Peter
Downey
Parker
Jr.
in high
said,
school.
Robert Downey Jr. was like, I don't know if I want to do anything after Avengers Age of Ultron, and then they signed him to like four more movies. Mm. Like, it's a negotiating ploy. You never be like, you never say like, I'll do 90 of these
for
free. For
free, yeah.
Because then you can't, you have to come to the table and be like, I don't want to do, like.
You have to play coy, yeah.
Fucking, same thing, Chris Hemsworth was like, I need Thor to go in a different direction, I want to do a third Thor.
Right, right.
And then after Thor 3, they signed him to a huge deal. You have to constantly act like you don't want to do this.
Right, right.
So they up your money. You know, if you're, you know, like. Yeah. It's like, because like me, I don't really want to do this.
Like me with the party gigs.
Yeah.
Like, I don't really want to do this. It's a bar mitzvah and it pays $300. All right.
Yeah, exactly. That's exactly how they got him to sign. I think with the stuff that's going on with Julie Louis-Dreyfus, I think it's going to come to the Dark Avengers.
I mean, I love Julie Louis-Dreyfus, mm-hmm. but how distracting is that?
So I think what's going to happen, I think Spider-Man's going to get involved, is we're going to see Dark Avengers.
Yeah.
Where Venom, I think Venom's going to be the Spider-Man in that. And you're going to have U.S. Agent. And I think it's going to be a movie. They're going to go right to Dark Avengers.
That'd be good.
And then the next movie after that, I think it's going to be a 1 year later, I think it's going to be New Avengers. And that's where you finally have Spider-Man and Shang-Chi.
Right.
And Moon Knight. And maybe I think the White Vision is going to be in Dark Avengers.
Yeah.
But I think you're going to see like the Green Vision come back. You're going to see like the new of like this, all these heroes you're using are going to come together.
Not me chortling. That's your dog,
that's
by the
dog.
Way.
She's excited about this idea. And then I think after New Avengers, you're going to see Secret Wars. And then I think we're going to see the X-Men. That's what I think. Yeah. I think they're leading to Dark Avengers. And my friend's like, Andrew Lee was like, they're not going to call it Dark Avengers because.
Because it's racist?
Yeah, and I'm like, no, Dark Avengers is a cool name. They want to market Avengers. So
yeah.
I think they're going to announce like that. So that's why I think Venom's in the MCU, so they can put him in that team.
Right, right.
Yeah.
By the way, how bad was Woody Harrelson?
He was bad, but I like that movie, though.
It was a fun movie.
It was way better than the first Venom.
Yeah.
You know why? Because it knew it was stupid.
Also, again, Venom, another character in the Spider-Man universe who's funnier than Spider-Man.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, Venom's pretty funny.
Now. Yeah.
Well, you know. But yeah, so I loved the I wasn't a big fan of the Ferris wheel fight where he's Night Monkey, although Night Monkey this time made me laugh. I thought it was kind of corny in the theaters. This time I was like laughing. I don't know, maybe I was tired.
Probably tired.
Or I'm getting older, but I thought the Night Monkey shit was funnier this time. I don't know why.
I don't know.
But I thought the final battle was just vintage Spider-Man. I loved it. I loved the final battle.
Yeah.
With the drones. I like the fact that when he got to Mysterio, it was just one punch to take him out.
Yeah, that was great.
Like, they didn't have Mysterio suddenly know Kung Fu or something.
Right,
bullshit.
Right.
I really liked the final battle. The cliffhanger was kind of stupid, but then again, like I said.
Cliffhanger is stupid.
January 6th.
People who've never been to New York probably think that's what New York is like, that we have constant, like, huge news bulletins.
Yeah.
And
you
could hear them, mm-hmm. like everyone, like two blocks away can hear CNN on the side of a building.
How great was it, though, to see J.K. Simmons?
Oh, it was great. The guy's great.
It was a huge pop.
Not even CNN. It's fucking, like, imagine Alex Jones mm-hmm. all of a sudden is broadcasting off the side of Madison Square Garden and half of New York can hear him.
Yeah.
Like, what?
Well, I do think they've got to tone down the Alex Jones thing. Hey, she didn't lick it. But
No, it's my coffee cup's empty.
Sorry.
Ray's dog tried going for my coffee.
I'm yelling at my dog. And now here comes, no, don't do that. Okay. Jesus Christ.
This is like a zoo, really. Yeah. Ray has a lot of animals here.
I have three animals. I do think they have to tone down the Alex Jones things, because if they're going to make J. Jonah like...
I don't think so. I think they should make J. Jonah Jameson talk about how every school shooting is staged.
No, the blip was fake.
And Spider-Man's fault.
The blip was fake. Everyone's a crisis actor.
Everyone's a crisis actor.
You know, and I say all this stuff is stupid. Like, they could have easily proved that he's not Spider-Man. But, dude, like, they walked into the Capitol on January 6th with Confederate flags and Nazi flags.
Yeah.
And people are still defending it, that it wasn't that big of a deal.
Yeah.
And that it's fine. And we still have people...
Dude, I love that they say that, like... There's one guy who had like a pro Auschwitz sweatshirt, which I don't even know that existed. Like, where do you go for pro Auschwitz sweatshirts? So one star, by the way. I found one on Amazon. I'm like, you know what? I'm gonna give them a bad rating and show them where I stand.
Oh, you can buy it?
Where do you think he got? He got it. People are selling pro Auschwitz.
I know there's a website called Stormfront.
That should be my merch now. Instead of piece of idiot merch, it should be pro Auschwitz.
Pro Auschwitz.
I bet people would buy it.
Pro,
especially like if I have a shitty set, they're like, I'll take five pro Auschwitz in an extra large.
Pro Thanos.
So fucking, you know, what crisis actor would go that far?
No. They're not saying they're crisis actors. They're saying that it was fine.
Oh, it was actually liberals, right? It was actually like
Antifa. No, that it was fine. It wasn't that big of a deal.
Oh, it wasn't a big deal. Okay.
Yeah, it was okay. They were just normal. It was just fine. So it's like, yeah, like if you... I'm convinced nobody reads anymore. I'm just convinced nobody reads anything. Because if people really read what happened at Auschwitz, there's no way you could like be pro-Nazi.
I mean, dude. I talk about this in my act sometimes, but people don't even. I mean, I don't know how we're going from Spider-Man Far From Home. Let's talk about the Holocaust now. But yeah, most Americans don't know what the Holocaust is. They don't.
They don't know what happened. How fucked up. Like they just think like that the Nazis like went and shot you and that. No, they made you want death. Like if you did get pulled in the work camps. And the whole thing was like, you know, the takeaway. The other thing that, like, it's funny, like, the whole Nazi, the eventual thing with Nazism was the women were no longer bisexual. They were just going to be, like, lumps of shit that you fucked to have more men.
Yeah, yeah.
Like, they were not going to have any form. They were going to be in camps. The women were eventually going to be. And
you know
like,
what it is? We need another good Holocaust movie. The last one is Schindler's List.
I heard Kubrick wanted to make a movie, and I think I read a book that he read. I read this book by a guy who was in Auschwitz. He was Dr. Mengele. Because that's the thing. You know, they didn't... Here's the thing. People think like the soldiers did it, and then they fucking had like rallies, and then they played Call of Duty. They made inmates do this shit. So they would gather Jewish people to pick up the bodies and shit.
Yeah.
It wasn't like the Nazis were like, oh, yes, let's do it. Let's go kill people. No. When the bodies were like in the... When the bodies were in the fucking gas chambers dead, they made Jews take the gold fillings out and all that stuff.
Yeah.
So it was like really insane shit. But
and if you didn't, they'd fucking shoot you in the head.
Yeah.
They'd kill
you.
They burn you.
You had to do it in order to live to see your family. Because like, okay, maybe if I hold out, I'll get out. And the guy did get out. The guy was Mengele's assistant. And the guy, he would do autopsies on like dead children because they were trying to recreate twins. They would murder twins.
Oh, they did a ton of experiments on twins.
And because they were like, we can recreate. So I do think like they just, I think a lot of people who are like pro Nazis now, like if you're like, I think there's like, they had a Jewish landlord that pissed them off. Like they didn't really like research it. Like, they met Modi's crowd.
I had a Ukrainian landlord and now I hate all Ukrainians. I get anyone you pay your rent to.
They sat a Modi show and a deal with a table of four Jewish women. Because no, don't get me wrong. There's some like annoying people out there, but like when you read about that, like, oh, I don't want this to happen to my worst.
I don't think it's a landlord thing. I don't think it's, Jews have like this whole.
But you get my
This whole thing about Jews being landlords, dude. How many Jewish landlords have you encountered?
Oh, the Hasidic Jews bought the building across the street from me.
Yeah, Hasidic Jews, but how many fucking Italians own property? How many? You know what I mean? Like, how many Asians own property? Chinese are buying up property left and right.
Well, yeah, there's Asian hate. Did you see it? Last year.
There's a little more Jewish hate than Asian hate.
All right, let's get back to
let's get back to that anti-Semite.
But you know what, like
Spider-Man.
This is why I also can't get into Eternals. Or did you try to watch Jupiter's Legacy?
No.
On Netflix. Okay.
I heard that was crap.
It was crap. Okay, so the guy gets his powers like 1929, and it takes place now, and he's had his powers since 1929, right? The guy Josh, whatever, he was in Transformers. And he's sitting with his brother. He's like, you know, we made a vow to never interfere in human events. We only... I know. We let World War II happen, Vietnam, 9/11. I'm like, whoa. You had your powers in 1929, and the Nazis were rounding up and murdering children.
Right.
You're just like, do they have any supervillains doing it? Can't help out. Sorry. Hands are tied. I'm going to go bust this... Like, what are you talking? What did you do? And I get, and same with Eternals. Like, you're telling me like the Eternals were on Earth and they're like, yeah, Hitler's killing all these Jews. Yeah,
right.
Well, you know, there's no deviants, so.
Yeah, yeah. Like, that, well, that's the big problem. It's like, is like when you have these huge tragic events, it's so hard to explain away why heroes wouldn't, like Wonder Woman.
Wonder Woman, World War One.
Why would she fight in World War One, not World War Two? Mm-hmm. She'd be like, you know, and she's Jewish.
See, to me,
she's an Israeli Jew.
She'd I know. Like, you think
nah,
she?
I already did one war. I can't do another.
No, she's depressed over this fucking Steve guy until 1984. Then does something because like, you know, she heard Thriller. And then, but like, dude, like, but that's the, like, I, dude, if I ever made a Captain America movie, I would literally start it like there'd be literally like they're all in the gas chamber. They're all in the gas chamber.
Yeah.
And they're about to die, and they're crying, and then the fucking shield opens the door, and he's just, and him and Bucky are fucking up
right,
Nazis.
Fucking up Nazis.
And they're like, get
that's
out of
that's what Captain America should be, fucking up Nazis.
The fucking cheer in that room, like they're about to shoot a kid in the fucking head, yeah. And Captain America comes through, and he's like, we're getting out of Auschwitz, and like, dude, the cheer in that room. Because that's what Captain America would do.
Right.
That's what Superman would do.
Yeah.
They wouldn't just be like, hey, whatever, you know what I mean? Like,
yeah, why would Superman not interfere? Just because his dad is like, you know, his dad is like, don't interfere in human events. Well, what the fuck are you supposed to do with these powers?
Well, now, I mean, he does to a certain extent.
But why didn't Superman, you know, stop the Holocaust and all that?
So in Earth 2, not in this Earth, he wasn't, that's why
he's Jewish too.
Not being around.
Yeah.
What happened was Hitler resurrected Merlin or Mordor or something, and they cast the spell over Europe so nobody with superpowers could get in.
Oh, okay.
So you only could send people with non-powers. So I think Green Lantern had to leave his ring and enlist in the army. Superman couldn't get into Europe.
Wow.
And Batman was just lazy, I guess. I don't know. He was like, why don't Batman go in there?
Yeah, they got like a lot of non-powered
but
people.
I do like that Hitler knows when he's okay, Superman's gonna come, but he
so it's just a bubble, like Superman, so even underground
he can't get in.
There's a big force field even yes. underground. You can't burrow through.
He can't help out any. He can't help anyone with any superpowers cannot get in, unless they take out Mordor.
Okay.
And I think the Justice League goes in the cover to kill Mordor, and that's how they win World War II. But that to me, all right, that at least makes sense. So Superman's got to send in Green Lantern and Wildcat and Sandman because they don't have any powers into Europe.
Yeah.
To get Mordor, that to me makes more
okay.
sense.
Yeah. Yeah, that makes the most sense.
And I think John Constantine's grandfather gets involved and. Like getting rid of this Nazi, like that makes more sense.
Then. Yeah,
I just don't feel like it. And Spider-Man, I could get why Spider-Man couldn't stop. I mean, he wasn't around for World War II, but if he was, I could understand it because it's like, all right, like, but I think he would take a shot at it. I mean,
dude, Hawkeye, or Green Arrow could stop Hitler.
I know.
They do a little sniper action. You know,
I think Green Arrow does go over there. Yeah.
Okay.
He doesn't have power, so he can get in there.
Yeah, get in there and shoot like a fucking, you know,
you
arrow.
Have failed. You have
with,
failed
with a,
these
with
Jews.
With a fist, get you know, knock out Hitler. you failed these Jews.
You failed these Jews. I
think the better explanation is that all the superheroes hate Jews, and they were pro-Holocaust. They were all pro.
Well, did you see Ann Coulter share? This is like, I shared a meme of all the superheroes saluting Kyle Rittenhouse.
Oh, God.
It's like, way to misunderstand superheroes.
Wow.
Way to misunderstand.
She really
Spider-Man.
Did that?
Yeah.
She said it thanks saluting Kyle Rittenhouse.
Yeah, like they're doing this and he's walking with his stupid fucking gun.
It's such a weird thing. I don't get that.
This country is going full like masks off.
Like even if you're for, let's say you're like, okay, you view that as self-defense, right?
Mm-hmm.
And that whatever, okay. Still it's a tragedy. It's not like I wouldn't be like that guy's
like,
a hero. Like,
if people
were murdered, and I know some, you know, when
they're claiming those people wanted to murder Kyle. I don't believe that. But let's say like I had fights in the comedy club, right? I like people get in my face. Let's say one time a guy got into my face, he hit me, I shoved him, and he fell and broke his neck. I shouldn't be celebrated for that. That's a tragedy, and that's gonna fuck up my entire life.
Yeah,
you know, Scott Hall, the wrestler, remember Razor Ramon?
Yeah.
Okay, so he was a bouncer. And some guy was attacking one of the girls at the club. I think it was his girlfriend. No, it was his girlfriend. And Scott Hall grabbed the guy. The guy had a gun. And Scott Hall was fighting because the guy was trying to shoot Scott Hall. And Scott Hall moved his hand, Scott Hall moved his arm. And the guy shot himself.
Wow.
And he didn't get arrested because it was self-defense. And he stayed with that woman longer, and he said that ruined his life. He was on drugs. That's why he was on drugs. His career fell apart when he got older. His marriage fell apart. He lost custody of his children.
Wow.
Because he never got over the fact that he murdered that guy. And it wasn't his, and like, he knows it's not his fault. And it was, and that guy was trying to kill Scott Hall. You can't tell me these people are trying to kill this kid and to celebrate it.
Yeah.
And to be like, this kid's great. Da, da, da. It's like, no, dude, this is a trap. Even if those people were trying to kill him, it's a tragedy. And that's the thing. They're dehumanizing these people. Spider-Man doesn't kill villains because it's a tragedy. If even Doc Octopus dies to Spider-Man, that's a tragedy.
I mean, well, now Kyle Rittenhouse is doing the Compound Media comedy tour.
He's
that's what's gonna happen. He's gonna be like a stand-up comic. That's what's gonna, and he's gonna be making jokes about it, I bet.
I think there was a comic. No, I think it was in the movie, one of the movies I saw. I think there was a comic where like a villain dies and Spider-Man cries. He's not like, yay.
Yeah, it's a tragedy.
Yeah,
it's
cries,
like,
and it was like a really bad person too.
Like, what are you so like? What? Like, it wasn't like. It wasn't like someone was invading his actual home. Mm. It wasn't like someone's attacking his mother or he's being robbed at gunpoint.
He walked, like he was walking with a military grade weapon.
Yeah.
And it's just the but they've done this. Like, they used to murder, anyway. The way that they constantly dehumanize liberals, and they've done this the entire time this country's been around.
Yeah.
They used to, you know, like white people who would hold anti-slave rallies would be murdered by people in town and people would be like, oh, good.
Yeah.
Yeah. Like, this is why there was no like really big
anti-slave movement.
They see
it as justifiable. Yeah. That's what's happening in this country. It's this continuous degradation.
And dehumanization
of someone who you disagree with. So you could eventually, you end up, you know.
There was a Senate. The whole reason why the South is so anti-black is, there was a movement when the country first started to kind of get rid of slavery, and a senator from the South didn't want to lose the votes because I think like because of slavery they had more volume or something, like, so he started this thing that blacks were violent and stupid and they needed to be slaves, be taken care of,
right?
And it was the humane thing to do, and he started this stereotype, and that's where we got the stereotype that black people are violent and stupid. That a lot of people in the South still believe, and it was only so his state could get more votes on the Senate floor.
Yeah.
So like all this stuff doesn't come from pure places, and I don't know, we just have it ingrained in us, and it's like, well, if you go back, anyway, Spider-Man. No, this is what the podcast is about.
Yeah.
We go all over the place.
Yeah.
I know it's supposed to be a Disney podcast.
Right.
We're talking about fucking senators and shit, but then like you try to tell people it's like those are anti-white facts. Well, yeah, I mean there's plenty of facts. Like, here's some pro OJ facts. He was a Naked Gun,
right?
Very funny movie. He was a great football player.
Yeah,
his jersey was retired. He had a great commercial. Here's another OJ fact. He murdered two people. So that's the thing. It's like you have to take the good with the bad.
Yeah,
you can't. Why don't we just focus on OJ's football accomplishments?
Well, he's a great social commentator on Twitter now.
I love his Twitter. I love how happy he is. He's the funniest guy in the world. Hey, what's up, Twitter world? It's just so funny. Like,
it's weird. He lives in an alternate universe where he didn't kill two people.
But you kind of have to act like that. You kind of have to be like that, because if he was like constantly apologizing or being remorseful, people, you kind of have to just be like.
So there's hope for Kyle Rittenhouse. He'll have a happy Twitter account. He'll be having like a cheerful, motivational message each day.
Well, the difference is I still have some doubt that OG actually did it. I do believe Kyle Rittenhouse. Well, we know he did it.
Kyle definitely did it.
Kyle definitely did it. Yeah. So.
And I don't know, man. It's weird. You don't have to like be a good actor anymore. On the like, he took the stand. Those tears. It was like such a bad acting job.
Well, you're not supposed to believe the videotape. You're not supposed to believe what you see. You're not supposed to believe what you hear.
Yeah.
You're not supposed to believe what you read. The facts are. And remember, it's when they said I did. What was what the woman said? The one whose daughter hates her. Kellyanne Conway. What is it? The facts.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
What does she call it?
Alternate facts.
Alternate facts. Or
yeah.
It's like facts are not. And that was the thing. And it's like, that's what the Nazis did. In 1984, the whole thing in that book was 2 + 2 = 4. 2 + 2
right.
We tell you it equals.
Yeah. No, people. People.
How do you know 2 + 2 = 4? Someone told you. Well, we're going to tell you it equals 5.
Right, right.
Yeah.
No, we're like in this weird world now, and it doesn't feel like it's ever gonna work out.
And that's why we need the X-Men. That's why we need the X-Men to make a...
It would be nice to squeeze in a few more good movies before everything just goes to shit.
Yeah, so let's get back to No Way Home because we really... Yeah. But like, this is kind of what this podcast is. It's just an interesting time in this world. The past 2 years have been very interesting. But like, No Way Home... No, fuck. Far From Home.
Yeah.
Nick...
Also, the other thing too.
Yeah.
Most of those kids wouldn't even... Like, they had a scene... What was that scene on the... It was on the bus, right? Mm-hmm. Where all the stuff is going on with the drones.
And he goes, look at the goat, and he jumps up.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. He wouldn't have to do any of that. They would all have their faces in their phones.
I know. They really do.
Like, him making any... Saying anything at all would actually attract attention to him.
They're like, wait a minute. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
She'd be like, oh my God, did you see what Trump tweeted? Wait, what?
Yeah, yeah.
And then you jump out the window and shit, yeah. I got, you know what, watching back the movie, I'm like, wow, Nick Fury's a real idiot in this movie, but it makes total sense because it's not Nick Fury.
Yeah.
You know? Because, man, when you go back, him and what's-her-name look really fucking stupid.
Yeah.
The other thing that's weird about the movie is, okay, guys, the other thing that was weird about No Way Home is don't get a fucking cat. So here's the situation. While I was doing the podcast, fucking the cat. Sorry. Even Maddie Smith has a studio, and I'm in my living room having the cat step on my fucking equipment.
She has it. Where the studio? Where?
I don't know. It just looks like she has a studio. How do these people edit their?
By the way, do you know OS? Do you know OS New York?
What's that?
There is So this guy. This guy who owns it was at one of my shows.
Mm-hmm.
Not one of my shows, just a show I was on. And he really liked my set. He invited me over. Last night they had a big anime convention party.
Yeah.
Which I should have invited you. I should have had you.
I'm not really into anime that much. You think I would be?
Well, you would have been into the costumes. Some of these
okay. Yeah, I'm always into hot girls dressed like cartoon.
I mean, characters. It was insane. Mm. It was so incredible. But anyway, this spot, he basically took like video game and comedy culture and put it in like a nightclub. Like type setting,
mm-hmm.
And it's amazing. They have like video games of every generation.
Oh, that would I would
yeah, all consoles, yeah. Including PC, Smash Bros. competitions, where you win like thousands of dollars.
PC of eating.
People drinking, hot chicks. Mm-hmm. You would have loved. It's a very cool spot. So shout out to OS NYC.
So let's wrap it up with two.
Let's wrap it up. Yeah, you're talking about Spider-Man.
Two things. The weird thing is, yeah. Why would Nick Fury call Spider-Man to fight these elemental monsters if that was like really...
Right.
And then he's like kind of getting nasty at Spider-Man because Spider-Man doesn't want to fight these monsters. The funny thing is in Homecoming, he can't wait to like fight crime. In this movie, he's like, he doesn't want to fight crime. Which is weird because now Happy, in the first way, Happy's like, no, just stay, be a kid. Now he's like, yeah, go out there in Europe, fight these monsters, like, fuck your aunt.
Yeah, Happy, yeah, oh, that, I guess, did not record that part.
Yeah.
Where
yeah,
we talked
yeah,
about
yeah,
Happy.
Yeah.
Yeah. So I was saying, like, with Happy would have been, Happy's top priority would have been trying to bang Aunt May.
Mm-hmm.
So he would have been like, you know what? Let me show her that I'm paternal.
Yeah.
And I'm looking out for her nephew. Mm. And if I were Happy, I'd go to her and be like, listen, for some reason, the government, they want to send your nephew to his certain doom. They want him to fight these godlike creatures. I told him not to. I just saved your nephew. Now, yeah. can I put my fingers in you? That would have worked.
That would have worked.
That would have worked. Instead, you know how much harder it is for Happy now to bang her after... He has got to come back. He's like, yeah, you know, we told him to fight, you know, I helped him fight monsters.
And now his identity got revealed to the entire world.
Yeah, the identity is revealed. He's like, she's like, what were you doing during all this? I was trying to build him a better suit to go to war. What? What do you mean? He's like, I got to look after him. He's fucking in high school. What, you know? So that's what I would have done.
Yeah. But overall, very good movie.
Very good movie.
I don't think it's really a Spider-Man movie. Very great Marvel movie. Awesome superhero movie. Not so much a Spider-Man movie.
Basically, you fast forward to the parts where he's fighting Mysterio.
If you, like I said at the beginning, if you put either Ironheart or, I don't know, like, fucking, yeah, if you put Ironheart in this movie, it's the same movie.
It's not a real Spider-Man movie.
No, it's a kid Iron Man movie.
Yeah, it's more kid Iron Man. Yeah, you know, the suit is. It's. I think that's why the new ones that's coming out. They needed a way to destroy his Iron Man, his Iron Spider suit, so he gets back to basics.
Yeah, know? I think that's what's gonna happen. Are you excited for No Way Home? That's the final thing I want to talk about.
Very. I'm excited like I was for Infinity War
and Endgame. Yeah. I think this was the nuclear weapon Hollywood unleashed to get us all back in theaters. I think a year ago they sat down with these actors because these actors. Want their, you know, the thing about these actors is they want movies in movie theaters to get their bonuses.
Yeah.
So I think a lot of the actors who would have said no to this idea 2-3 years ago said yes a year ago because they're like, no, we do need to do something drastic and fan service-y to get everyone back in the theaters. And I think this is gonna be the moment where even the fucking most introverted person makes it to the movies to see this thing.
Yeah. I it would have been nice to see that guy. What's his name? Hammond, the guy who played 1980s Spider-Man.
Oh, I wouldn't be surprised if he's in it.
Yeah,
I bet you he's in it.
Yeah, I feel like that guy needs. He's the first guy,
dude. He would have done it in a second.
Yeah. You know,
he's in Australia, so I could see him like making a cameo on Zoom or something.
They should give him something.
They will.
Come on,
I think
first guy, zero budget. They're saying. I
would
like,
give him this.
I was watching an interview with them. He was saying like, yeah, it was like very expensive for CBS. That's why they canceled it. I'm like, what qualifies as expensive for CBS?
Well, have you seen some of those other
when
CBS
Spider-Man
shows?
Is like, you have him crawling. It was like 60s Batman. It was so cheap. Like 5 cents was too expensive for CBS.
Have you seen some of those CBS shows back then?
Jesus Christ.
They had no budget. Allan, let's go before the cat ruins this podcast.
Yeah, let's get out of here.
What do you have to plug?
All right, I'm going to be...
This will be out on Friday.
Friday? All right, awesome. Yeah, I'm going to be at Rob's Comedy Playhouse. Rob's Comedy Playhouse this weekend. If you live in the Buffalo area and you're a fan of this podcast, come on out. I'll be selling pro Auschwitz sweatshirts. Birkenau koozies.
Where else are you gonna get this in-depth Holocaust talk on a Spider-Man podcast?
Yeah, it's gonna be amazing.
Only here on Gootz's Disney Pod.
Zyklon B baseball caps. that's a deep Holocaust cut.
I'm gonna be at the Comedy Store selling Confederate flags for the next ride in the Capitol. Guys, what else? Social media? How can they?
Social media at Allan Fuks, AllanFuks. The Week in Sex podcast with my co-host, Keanu C. Thompson. Go follow her on OnlyFans. She's showing her titties on there. Go have a great time. Jerk off on Christmas and Thanksgiving. And have fun out there, guys.
Guys, you can see me. If you'll see this on Friday, I'll be at the Comedy Store and Flappers. That's about it. But the other shows happen before this comes out. Before this comes out. Follow me on social media, Ray Gootz. Go to my monthly show at The Stand, The Ray Show, or the fuck it's called. I forget what we call that show, but it's monthly. Also, follow me on Instagram, Twitter. I said that, Ray Gootz. Subscribe to the podcast. If this is your first time listening to the podcast, we've done every Spider-Man movie. We've done every Disney animated film. We've done every Pixar film. Next week, we're wrapping it all up with Venom, Let There Be Carnage, which with Mike Lawrence, not your arch nemesis, but Mike Lawrence will be back to talk Venom. He loved it, so I'm excited to talk with him about it because I think he gets what this movie was going for. And that's where we're going to wrap up the season. And then in 2 weeks, we are starting the Star Wars season. We're going to cover everything from Star Wars to the Ewoks films to the prequels to the new stuff that no one likes. So it should be fun, right, Allan?
It should be a great time. Should so much to look forward to.
So much to look forward to. Thank you so much for listening to our Nazi podcast that had also Spider-Man getting fucked.
Jews are good people. Don't hate them just because they own your building.
Listen, they raised the rent. Everyone needs some extra matzo balls. So don't hate it. We'll talk to you next week when we get to Venom. Let There Be Carnage.